coming. My name is Natalie Jackson. I'm with Ben Crump Law. Mr. Crump is in New York at the Buffalo mass shooting stuff today, so he's not able to join us. But I am joined today by attorney Shannon Liggins, activist Luana Delver, and also Derek Diaz's family. I'm joined by his stepfather, his aunts, and his cousins. And his brother is here too, Jordan. And so this is Sonia Nava. Sonia is the mother of Derek's five-year-old daughter, Yana Luz. So, as you know, we saw the video today. Yesterday, we received the call. No, you can hear me. Yesterday, we received the call and was told that the family would be able to come to the police station at 8:30 this morning to view the video. The family was very eager to come view it because they thought that they would get answers to their questions. However, once we got here, we were told that no questions would be answered, that they would be shown three videos, that they would not be able to read the police report, and they could only see the video one time. So that was our video, and they said that after this, they would release it to the media. As you know, you guys, it's now been released to the media. What we saw on the video left more questions than answers. So what we saw in the video was what we always knew, that Derek was peacefully, because he's a peaceful person by all accounts, that an unarmed Derek Diaz was sitting peacefully in a legally parked car when he was aggressively approached by three armed police officers. And in less than 1 minute, he was shot and bleeding. So the family is just really devastated. His mother is not here today. She is sick from what she's learned and from seeing the video. And we just wanted to come here and give our reactions and say that we really would like to see and read the police reports and gather more evidence in this case. We have so many questions, such as why did the police approach Derek Diaz in the first place? Such as why did they say downtown Orlando, which is Jefferson and Orange Avenue, was a drug-ridden area. It's an area where college students hang out, and it's two blocks from the courthouse, as you know. So we just have so many questions and so much more evidence and facts to gather in this case. And I know Sonia wanted to say her reaction up to the video. Once again, this is Sonia Nava, the mother of Yana Luz.
Our daughter, she's still asking questions about her father, and then it's really heartbreaking. Orlando. Today, the Orlando Police Department let us view the video only 10 minutes before they released it to the public. We had no time to go over like what happened. Like, we were still taking the video in, and it was already released to the public just 10 minutes after we had viewed it. All we know from that video is that Derek was sitting in his car. He was not doing anything wrong. Three aggressive officers approached him, and he was scared. Less than a minute, like Natalie said, he was dead. They had already shot him. The video was so sickening to watch, I threw up while watching it. We have so many answers. While we were watching it, we were told that they weren't going to answer any questions, that they wouldn't let us re-watch it. We got to watch the three videos one time. They said we had to leave, and that was it. And they said that they would be releasing the video immediately.
And so, Shannon, Livin, do you have something to say? This is Attorney Shannon Livin. She's a local attorney who's worked on these types of cases here in Orlando.
Good afternoon. Thank you all. While I am an attorney and civil rights and criminal defense attorney of 15 years, I stand here today as a resident and citizen of downtown Orlando and a business owner. My heart goes out to the Diaz family. This unfortunately happened on Jefferson Street, where I practiced for over 15 years. For them to allege that criminal activity and drug activity is occurring here in downtown Orlando is absurd. It's happening all over our nation just as much as it's happening in D.C. and Windermere. So for our citizens' rights to be trampled and and our constitutional rights to be overlooked and this family not to be afforded every right to inspect this video. We cannot let this stand. So I ask our citizens, and most importantly, I ask our governor to take corrective action to not only reform Stand Your Ground laws, but also to address the real concerns of over-policing in our communities, because these families should not have to go through this. We advocate on these steps yearly because of these issues. So again, my heart's to the Diaz family, but we want to ask OPD to do the right thing and also ask that these officers be brought to justice for the unlawful killing of Mr. Diaz. Thank you.
Luana Gelzer, after reviewing the video, of course I was heartbreaking, but more so, less than 41 seconds, a person's life was taken. But the question that has been repeatedly stated was, they came with their guns drawn already. What crime had he committed? So I'm pleading to each and everybody within my voice that sees this, show up at City Hall Monday the 17th at 2 p.m. We're going in because we've seen so much money allocated for police training. Where is the training? And in closing, the city of Orlando has not changed their use of force metrics. They have the worst use of force metrics in the country, only 4 levels. We don't stand a chance. If we're in our car, if we're somewhere that they want us to be, they are the judge, jury, and executioner. And so the people of Orlando need to understand, we can no longer take this. With all the money we've allocated for training, those officers do not need to use wear that badge. So please show up Monday at City Hall. Thank you.
And so we'll take a few questions. I know the family is preparing for the funeral on Friday, so this will be very short. Yes. Yes. Say your name.
Mi nombre es Antonia Diaz. Soy tía de Derek. Me parece muy injusto lo que hizo la policía, porque uno como ciudadano tiene derecho de parquearse en cualquier parqueo. Él no estaba haciendo nada malo. Simplemente estaba parqueado y ellos llegaron. Estaban ahí 3 policías agresivos que en un minuto le quitaron la vida sin darle derecho ni la oportunidad de que se defendiera ni decir nada. No lo cuestionaron, no hicieron ninguna pregunta. Lo mataron. ¿Por qué? No tenían derecho.
Esta mañana cuando vieron el video, ¿cómo fue el proceso para que les dejaran ver el video y cuál fue su reacción inicial?
No, el proceso fue ya... Ellos habían hablado con el abogado, estando allá en la zona. Y cuando lo vimos fue una cosa importante para nosotros. No esperábamos eso, porque estábamos buscando la respuesta, qué fue lo que pasó, qué hizo Dere, por qué lo mataron, por qué quitarle la vida de esa manera. Si era un niño tan inofensivo, él no hizo nada, él obedeció todas las leyes. Ellos le dijeron, quédate tranquilo, él se quedó tranquilo con su mano puesta en el volante, ¿por qué tenía que quitarle la vida? Para nosotros, eso lo hicieron ellos por racismo, porque él no hizo nada malo, que pudieran quitarle la vida a él.
¿Cuánto tiempo les dieron para ver el video?
Attorney Jackson, are you all, what are you all calling for now? The arrest of the officer? What are the next steps now?
No, we're still in an investigative stage. Like I said, there's so many questions. We don't know. We were shown a video without any context. So we were not allowed to ask questions. We were not allowed to read a video, a police report. Our first question would be, what was the justification to approach Derek in the first place? So that would be our first question.
A Attorney Jackson, also real quick, we heard that you may have been live streaming the incident when it happened. Did you know that?
No, we did not know that.
Well, I'm saying, is that true or?
We don't know anything about that. Okay. We haven't heard that.
What are some of the other main family mentions that you guys have along or questions on the city want to answer? What are some of the main questions that you all have or the family has about?
Well, I think the main question would be, from a legal perspective, is that what was the reason to approach the other people? So if the reason was, as we believe, maybe the smell of marijuana, then why would a death sentence be imposed for that?
Did they ever tell you that's the alleged drug they claim was found?
No, we have not heard what the, we just keep hearing the word narcotic. And I do want to say that Derek did have a marijuana, medical marijuana card. He suffered with anxiety. So that goes into play when you're dealing with police officers and when they're being very aggressive with someone, you know, things that they do and how they react as their reaction time is low. So I think that all of this is about police training.
Yes.
And we want to make sure that police are being trained to deal with citizens, especially in the downtown area where a lot of college students are, where there's a lot of young people who are out, you know, having fun and they may be using marijuana. We want to make sure that police are trained to deal with these and that they don't end up like Derek Diaz.
Attorney Jackson, with downtown being such a busy spot for young adults, this officer has only been with the department for 3 years. Do you think that's enough experience to patrol such a busy area like this?
I would say that that's a question for the police department and their training and their policies. I would think that an area like this where we want to encourage tourism, we want to encourage young people. We know that this is a young person hot spot, and we know when you have young people, sometimes they are not listening or they're not responding the way that maybe some people should. There should be officers training how to deal with that type of, those type of encounters. And I didn't use de-escalation because there was no escalation on Derek's part.
Chief Smith offered an apology, saying he offers his sincerest condolences to you all, the family.
I don't believe that they have had that from Chief Smith. He has not talked to the family.
Sanja, where do you and your family go from here? You and your 5-year-old daughter, where do you all go from here? Reaction again when you saw that video for the first time?
I threw up in the police station while watching the video.
What's your reaction to know that OPD, they slowed down the video on social media and then circled an item being thrown out of the car?
I think that once again, everything that we all the evidence that we're calling for is the complete investigation so that we can see everything. I'm not sure what OPD has provided to us. I'm not sure if it's in the context. I'm not saying that it's not. I'm just saying that this family obviously is very not secure that they're getting all the information. So I think that when you talk about transparency, which I believe the chief did talk about, when you talk about transparency, then I think that's complete transparency. I believe that is, you know, giving them the information that you have. So our reaction to what we saw is that it's not the complete evidence and we need to see the complete video.
But do you have an assessment of what you were able to see after they pulled him over as far as when they were giving them information?
We use a police use of force expert that will give us that assessment, and the experts, they'll know what policies, if any, were violated by the police force, and they'll know if under Florida and federal law, if this was a justified shooting. So without, you know, getting into that, I think that we'll rely on the expert report.
Attorney Jackson, I have a question for the family. The officers and detectives have yet to recover the gun from the scene. So I know that there's others that he's never owned a gun legally or illegally, never had one.
Y'all released the funeral details? Is the funeral open to the public?
So, the funeral details will be released. However, the family will not be giving any interviews during the funeral. Obviously, if the media wants to come and take pictures of the procession, they can, but there won't be any interviews during that time.
And would Derek's brother like to say anything? He's spoken out before and it's been pretty vocal.
Yeah. Now, it was a very traumatic day this morning for everybody, so I think, like I said, this will be a short press conference. I knew you guys just wanted a reaction, so I wanted to make sure that we were able to get the family's side of everything. And so there is
we just wanted to ask that you guys share this GoFundMe. I'm not sure how you guys will share it, we can send you guys the link, but it's on the Yanetti Diaz, it's YANERIDS.
Hey, can I ask one more question? In his statement, he says, I want to express my sincere condolences to the Diaz family on the loss of their loved one. We understand the need for answers.
Right.
What's your reaction to that?
Well, then I would ask the chief to please provide them to the family. I don't think that they've seen that statement, so I think this is the first time that they've heard that. Thank you very much.